In the previous class, we discussed up to the concept of capacitance of a conductor. Today, we start discussion with capacitor. So, what is capacitor actually? In simple way, we can say capacitor is a device which can store some electric charge and energy temporarily. So, how can you make a capacitor? Whatever may be the type of capacitor, remember, to make a capacitor, you have to take two conductors which are oppositely charged, separated by a small distance with an insulating medium. Clear? So that's why in the definition we can say capacitor is a device which is consisting of two oppositely charged conductors separated by an insulating medium which can store some electric charge and energy. Now see here, I draw two diagrams. This diagram represents the capacitor with fixed capacitance. This diagram represents the capacitor with variable capacitance. So what do you mean by capacitance? It is the ability of capacitor to hold some electric charge and energy. Mathematically, the capacitance of a capacitor is given by C equal Q by V. So what is Q actually? The charge on either conductor, and V the potential difference between two conductors. And the SI unit of this capacitance is farad, that is denoted by capital F. Okay, so remember there are three types of capacitor. Number one, parallel plate capacitor, cylindrical capacitor and spherical capacitor. Among these, we have to read only about parallel plate capacitor. So what do you mean by parallel plate capacitor? A parallel plate capacitor consisting of two conducting plate, among which one is positively charged and other is negatively charged. Firstly, we determine the expression for capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor whenever the space between the two plate is filled by air. Air means actually it is the vacuum space. For this, see this diagram carefully. We consider here a parallel plate capacitor consisting of two parallel plate, yes, among which one is positively charged and other is negatively charged. The electric field between these two plate is directed from positive to negative plate. Clear? Okay. A be the plate area of each plate, plus minus sigma be the uniform surface charge density on the two plates, plus sigma for positive plate, minus sigma for negative plate. Clear? So now, to determine the expression for capacitance, two things we have to know from this formula. One is charge and number two is potential difference. Clear? To determine the charge on each plate, we have to know the expression for electric field between these two plates, which we know from the first chapter. The electric field between these two plates is given by sigma by epsilon naught. Okay, where sigma be the surface charge density of the plate and epsilon naught be the permittivity of free space. Clear? So now, potential difference between the two plates, V equal ED. From where we got this equation? In this chapter, we get a relation between electric field and potential as E equal dV by dr. Means electric field is equal potential difference by distance. That's why I write potential difference is equal electric field into distance, where dV the separation distance between the two plates. What is the value of E? From equation number 1, V equal sigma dy epsilon naught. So this is the expression for potential difference between these two plates. So now from definition of capacitance C equal Q by V. So what is Q? The total charge on the plate. So total charge is equal, we know it is the product of surface charge density into area. So surface charge density is sigma and area is A. So that's why in place of Q I write sigma A and in place of V I write sigma D by epsilon naught. So where sigma cancel, so C becomes epsilon naught A by D. So this is the expression for capacitance. Now from this equation, we can say the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor, it depends on these three factors. Number one, permittivity of free space. The capacitance is directly proportional to the permittivity of free space when A and D are constant. Similarly, C is proportional to the area of plate when epsilon naught and D are constant. Similarly, C is inversely proportional with the separation distance D here when epsilon naught and A are constant. So therefore on these three factors, epsilon naught, A and D, the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor depends. There is a very important point you have to remember. Here this is the expression for capacitance when there is a vacuum between the two plates. Now if the total space between the two plates filled by other medium of permittivity K, so then the new capacitance becomes C dash is equal K into C. That is, K is the permittivity of given medium and C is the capacitance with vacuum space between the two plates. Okay, so this thing is very important for 1 or 2 mark short question. Remember it. So now next we move into the concept of combination of capacitor. As you people read in class 10 the combination of resistor, here we read the combination of capacitor. There are two possible combination. One is series combination and other is parallel combination. Okay, so now during these two type of combination, what is the effective capacitance of the combination? You have to determine. Here only you remember the formula, because only formula is required to solve the numerical. Deduction of formula is not important. Okay, so whenever the capacitor of capacitance like C1, C2, C3 are connected like that across a voltage source, and this type of connection then is called the series connection of the capacitor. And during the series connection, you have to remember the equivalent capacitance of this combination can be determined by the formula 1 by Cs is equal 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. Clear? And now for parallel combination. Okay, whenever the capacitor are connected like that across a source, and this type of connection then is called the parallel combination of capacitor. So during the parallel combination of capacitor, the equivalent capacitance can be determined by the formula C1 plus C2 plus C3. These two formula, either for series or parallel, both formula are applicable for any number of capacitor, not only for 2 or 3, for any number of capacitor. To determine the equivalent capacitance of the combination, we can use this formula. Clear? Next, we know about the energy stored in capacitor. This deduction is very important for your exam purpose. This is a repeated question. Energy stored in a capacitor. Okay, to determine the energy stored in capacitor, we take the reference of a parallel plate capacitor. Just see here, parallel plate capacitor. This is positive plate having a charge Q dash. This is negative plate having a charge minus Q dash. Electric field directed from positive plate to negative plate. First, we have to know how the energy stored in the capacitor. Okay. So now, as there will be some potential difference between the two plates. If we move some charge from one plate to the other plate, then there will be some amount of work done. And this work done stored as the energy in the capacitor. Okay, so now first we move a small amount of charge dq from negative plate to positive plate. Okay, for which the small amount of work done is given by dw. What is the definition of work done? Potential into charge. Actually, potential means potential difference between the two plate into charge. Okay, so V is the potential difference, which is from the definition Q dash by C, where C is the capacitance of this capacitor. So therefore, dW equal Q dash by C into dQ dash. Now finally, you are moving the charge Q from negative plate to positive plate, for which total work done, we have to integrate this equation. So therefore, W equal 1 by C constant, then integration, initially transfer amount of charge is 0 and finally you transfer a charge Q, that's why limit is 0 to Q, Q dash dQ dash. And according to integration formula, it becomes Q dash square by 2, lower limit, upper limit. So that's why first I put the upper limit, that is Q square by 2 minus lower limit means 0 square by 2, means it only gives Q square by 2. And here C means the work done is Q square by 2C. This is one of the expression of work done. Okay, from here, in place of Q, we can write CV. So Q square means C square V square by 2C. 1C cancels, that is half CV square. So this work done stored as the energy in the capacitor. That is U equal Q square by 2C is equal half CV square. Okay, both the expression you have to remember, because both formula required for solving the numericals. Now to determine this expression, we take the example of parallel plate capacitor. This does not mean that this is only the expression for energy of parallel plate capacitor. For any type of capacitor, the expression for energy stored U equal Q square by 2C or half CV square. Clear? So now, this is only for the single capacitor. If I provide you the combination of capacitor, like series combination or parallel combination, then how can you determine the energy? For any type of combination, whether it is series or parallel, the total energy of the combination can be written as U equal U1 plus U2 plus U3 plus dot dot dot. Means the total energy of the combination is equal to the sum of the energy stored by the individual capacitor for any type of combination, either for series or parallel. Thank you.